everybody, welcome to Danielle's Essentials YouTube channel. I'm here today because this came in the mail finally, and I was so excited I didn't want to wait any longer to open it. So I'm throwing together this really quick video to unbox it. So we're here again in my bedroom. It is pretty late here. It's about 7:45. My mail just got here. It got here really late, so I was excited. So here's the card with all the information on the back, and then this is what it looks like. Lots of goodies. So I'm gonna open everything up, swatch it, tell you how much it cost, and you'll probably hear my dogs because they're on the bed here with me. So we're gonna start off with the Ofra Advanced Vitamin C Cream, and this right here, Ofra. Okay, this is $50, and it does contain SPF 20. I wonder if it smells like really. It's not super strong of SPF, like it doesn't have that strong scent. Let's squeeze a little on our hand here. And it just exploded on me, so that was more than I was gonna put on. So now we'll just lotion up my hands since I've got so much of it. Oh, now it's a really, it's a stronger SPF scent. But not bad. But be careful when you open it because now my tube looks like that. This is full size, so I don't know if you can tell how big it is. That's how big it is. Shh. They're whining, they want down. And the next thing we have here is Bare Minerals Gen Nude. I haven't tried any of the Bare Minerals lip products, and this is a lip gloss in buttercream. I have a little bit of lip product on my lip now from working today, but this is what it looks like. This looks like it's going to be way, way too light for me, but for purposes of this video, I'll go ahead and put it on my lips. Ooh, there's the doe foot. So, yeah. Unless I go really thin, and just, ooh, that smells good. If I put it a little too thick, it'll be too light for me. I actually still think it's a little too light for me, but that's what it looks like. Let me swatch it on my hand for you. I'll try to keep it all to the front of my hand since we've got a lot of products to swatch today. That's what it looks like. It looks a lot better on my hand than I think it does on my lips. But it's a little goopy on my lips. I think I put a little too much on my lips. The next item we have is the Sigma Small Taper Blending Brush. It is an E45. Let's get this out of the plastic. And that's what it looks like, and that's what the brush looks like. Nice tapered brush. I don't have any Sigma brushes currently, so this will be nice to add to my collection. It's really soft. Excuse Princess and her barking. The next thing, oh, you know what? I didn't tell you the price of the Bare Minerals. The Bare Minerals lip gloss is $18. I have it upside down. $18. And then the Sigma brush is going to be $16. And then up next we have the Becca First Light Priming Filter. That's what that looks like. And this runs $18. Now this looks like it's like a deluxe sample. This doesn't look full size. But let me try to get that open. My dogs are trying to get out the door.
Chloe, no. Get in bed. Get in bed.
This is what it looks like. It is really, like, holographic-y. I don't know if you can see that on there. But let's open this up. It's got a seal. Sorry, it's a little late. I've worked all day. I was ready to go to bed. And I was like, let me check the mail again. And sure enough, this was there. I was actually expecting something else. So I was happy to see that this came in. It does come out purple. And again, ignore my crying dogs. It's really, really like watery. That's it up here. But as you can see, it does have some shimmer-ish in it. That's even a word. But there it is right there. Beautiful, beautiful primer. And I did say that was 18. So on to the next product. We are gonna do the Makeup Geek. I don't have anything for Makeup Geek either, so this is something new for me. This is an eyeliner pencil. If I can get the sucker open. I'm sorry, you guys are kind of aiming towards the ceiling and not so much on me. I don't know what the deal is right now. My iPad's so big, I have the iPad Pro, that it's hard to use the pillows to prop it up. So this does not have, this appears to be a different color, not a black. So nice that it's something different. It's actually like a purple or burgundy. That's it right there. Let me see if it says what color it is. Makeup Geek. Oh, Palmeria. That's an interesting, different color. That probably would look good today. Today I am wearing the Laura Lee Los Angeles Cats pajamas today. I've got the shimmery red. I don't know the colors. I don't have my palette on me. On my eyelid, if I can talk. I've got the black on the palette on the sides. I did my crease color. I used a Tarte palette just for the crease color, but you can't tell. It was a brown color, but it is very pigmented. I wasn't planning on going that black on the sides. I just tapped the black once with my brush and went in just to put a little bit of black, and then it was like boom, all there. So very good palette, very, very good palette. I'm so happy with it. And then the Makeup Geek eyeliner runs $9. And then up next we have Pure, and it says Big Look, and it's a mascara. Now I have a lot of open mascaras, so I don't want to open this one to show you the wand. But this runs $21. It is full size. And we have two items left. The next item we have is the Cover FX in Custom Enhancing Drops. And now I did get a small bottle of this in one of my other boxes last month, so I'm excited to have a full size. I know I probably won't use a full little one, so I most definitely won't use a full big one, but I'll definitely give it a try. Now this is $42, and this is in the color Blossom. So let's open this up and dab a little bit and see what that looks like. So that's what the big bottle looks like. I think the little bottle is like that big. Let's swatch this on our hand to see what it looks like. And so it comes in a little vial, a little drippy thing like that. I'm going to drop a little one because last time I dropped a big drop and I almost covered my whole hand. So that's what it looks like. And then let's ignore their barking. And then that's it right there. Beautiful, beautiful for a highlight. Do whatever excess I have on my finger. So I'm excited about that. When I heard that that was going to be in there, I was like, yes, it's going to hopefully be a different color than my little sample. And it was. And lastly, last but not least, we have a Tarte palette. Gorgeous color. It looks like it's got 6 shadows and a blush. So this is Miracles of the Amazon Eye and Cheek Palette. If I can ever get the box open. Oh, here I go. I'm ripping it. Shh. Quiet. Oh, I love, 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 love the packaging. I love purple, so I love the package. Let's open it up. Of course, it has the plastic with all the names. But that's what it looks like. I don't want to show you my whole room. That's what it looks like. Let's do it this way. There we go. A lot better. So it looks like we have lots of browns, which works great because I like the burgundy in the Laura Lee palette, as well as her the burgundy reddish colors in her collab with ColourPop, sorry. I love those deep red colors, so but as far as other palettes that have like purples in here, like this looks purple, but it's actually a brown. So is this. The color in here isn't doing it justice, but they are browns. And I love browns. Browns are my color. Purples don't look good on me. Light colors like pinks don't look good on me with my skin tone. So I'm happy that I got the palette with the browns. So let me go ahead and swatch these on my hand for you. This gold color looks good. So there's the gold and the two browns. And that's on the side that it looks purple, but it's not. And then the other side, so the one side is 2 mattes and a shimmer, and the other side is 2 shimmers and a matte. Ooh, that brown came out amazing. And one last color. So, oh great, I always put them on the side, you can't see. So there's the matte, and then there's the 2 shimmers, and then there's a shimmer, and then the 2 mattes. So, beautiful colors. Now let's try the blush. And there's the blush. It's a little bit of a pink, but not too much. It's more of a peach color. Not too pink. That will be my 3rd Tarte blush. And I don't use a lot of blush, so it'll last me a long time. It'll probably go bad before I can even complete, like, break into the pan. So, I am happy with my box. I've seen a video that came up on YouTube of somebody who wasn't happy with their box. I'm happy with it. I like it. I'm glad I got a different color eyeliner because I've got a million black eyeliners, so this makes me try stuff out of my comfort zone. So I'll definitely give it a try. Brushes. You can never have too many brushes. Like, I love getting brushes in my boxes. It just adds to my collection. The only thing I'm not too excited about is the Bare Minerals lip gloss. It's too light for me. I'm not too much of a shiny lip person, so I'll probably use this on like the light makeup days, not on a heavy makeup day like I am today. But everything else I absolutely love. Mascaras, we get a ton of mascaras. I'm a big fan of the Chanel mascara, like I've said before, but I'm almost out. I do have samples, but I'll definitely give all the other mascaras a try. I still haven't thrown away the Katy Perry one yet. I saw it yesterday when I was reorganizing my makeup and trying to pick out my makeup to wear for today, and I was like, I really need to throw that away. I definitely won't be using it. But as far as this limited edition box, was it worth it? Yes, I think it was really worth it. a lot of great brands, a lot of brands that I didn't already have, more browns to add to my collection because you can never have too many browns. Every brown's just slightly different. Can always need more primer, more moisturizer. I mean, I absolutely love it. I just by luck was able to get in and order the limited edition box when I got my link for my BoxyCharm. I just tried and tried and tried and tried and tried. And I just ordered the one. I wasn't gonna order a whole bunch. I just wanted one for review purposes to post on YouTube and one for me to have the products to try. So I'm happy with it. If they came out with another one, I definitely would purchase it. I think BoxyCharm's value for what the cost of the box is, even the limited edition, is so worth it. I was telling somebody at work today, if you're just starting to get into makeup, BoxyCharm is the best box to go with because it's full-size products, great brands, and you get amazing brands, you know, and you just grow your makeup collection from there. And she definitely was going to go home and look at it. So I love BoxyCharm. BoxyCharm can never go wrong in my eyes anyways. But as far as the whole issue with the limited edition box, as other people purchasing it, yeah, that was kind of sad, but they were new at doing this, so, you know, things happen. There was no reason for people to be upset. You know, it was something new to them. They thought it was going to work one way, and it didn't, unfortunately, and, you know, they learned from their mistakes, and the next time they come out with a box, you know, they'll know how to do it right the next time. So I'm not upset. Even if I didn't get a box, I wouldn't have been upset. You know, it was their first time. You can't blame them. It's something new. You know, when stores open, you know, they don't get things right the first time. Just like when they build a brand new car, make a brand new car, that first year of that vehicle, you know, it's going to have bugs. It's going to have issues that come out. That's just something that happens when you do something for the first time. So, thanks for listening to my rant. I am going to unbox all this stuff and put it on my makeup table and take off this makeup on my face and get ready for bed and then just keep an eye out. Hopefully boxes start rolling in here soon so we can keep the unboxings coming. I did get a notification from Macy's that they drafted out of my account, so I'll finally get to review the Macy's box, so I'm excited about that. So keep an eye out on that in the future, and thank you for joining me. Please make sure you subscribe and like this video, and as a reminder, don't forget, I'm doing a giveaway when we get to 50 subscribers, so make sure you subscribe to be entered into that giveaway. Thank you for joining me, and you have a great night.